All around our village on Lantau, there are new houses being built, and we can see into their shells because they are pocketed with holes for windows. Some holes are large and some are small, but each concrete house is made to let in plenty of light for the interior. The contrast of light and darkness are one of the persistent themes of Scripture and of our lives. Beginning with God's division and creation of light and darkness, day and night, these two states have illustrated our physical, daily lives, but also our spiritual lives. Although the Bible is full of talk about darkness and light, three writers use the contrast more than others. These are Isaiah, Job, and John. The prophet Isaiah uses the visual contrast to speak of the spiritual darkness and illumination in our lives. He also uses it to prophesy the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. But the book of Job speaks of light and darkness in a way familiar to the whole world. In Job, the idea of darkness is associated with death, and often with the ancient world's phrase, the shadow of death. This was the view of the world, that the mysterious life after death was one of shadows, sadness, and darkness. Job's sad words were typical of the old world's expectations. Hear him in chapter 10, verses 20 through 21. "Before I go whence I shall not return, even to the land of darkness and the shadow of death, a land of darkness as darkness itself, and of the shadow of death, without any order, and where the light is as darkness." Shakespeare has this same old world idea in the mouth of Hamlet, who says, "There is a dread of something after death, the undiscovered country from whose bourne no traveler returns." But Hamlet was mistaken, for there is a traveler who has returned from the shadow of death and from the grave itself. I'm speaking, of course, of Jesus Christ, who is himself the resurrection and the life. We recently celebrated Easter, the victorious culmination of the Holy Week, with all its focus on suffering, death, and the stone-cold tomb. John's Gospel tells us that Jesus Christ is the light of the world, and in him was life, and the life was the light of men. And the light shineth in the darkness, and the darkness comprehended it not. This word comprehend is rich in meaning. It can include ideas of understanding, overcoming, embracing, surrounding. But in all that it can mean, we know that not only did the darkness of this world not only reject Jesus, but Jesus triumphed over its darkness. In other words, the darkness was not victorious over the light of Jesus Christ. His light could not be concealed in a tomb, and unlike other graves in the world, his borrowed resting place is empty today and ever will be, for he lives forever. Because his light still shines, those who are in him, those who have accepted his gift of salvation, are called to walk in the light which he provides. 1 John chapter 2 tells us that our love towards one another is one indication that we are walking in the light. During the time of the global pandemic, when people are practicing social distancing, in some ways they're in more intense relationships with folks that they had not been before. Some have heard and may have seen in the news that in many cases there are domestic disputes. There are breakdowns in relationships between employers and family members and husbands and wives and parents and children, because there is a challenge of loving one another as we are called to do. But Christians, if we are truly a child of the light, if we've truly trusted Jesus Christ as our Savior and we are children of the light, our love towards one another, our love towards even those who are unloving to us, is one indication that we are living and walking in the resurrection light of Jesus Christ. So this week, as we follow up on Easter, let us remember that the grave of Christ is empty, the light of Christ still shines, and the Christian's call is to walk in the light which death itself cannot dim. Yes, at Easter we celebrate the empty grave, we celebrate the resurrection of Jesus Christ, we celebrate the light of the world, but we also remember this week and every week that the light still shines.